Hi friends, welcome back. The circuit we just discussed in our previous session is going to amplify and give the output in the inverted version of the input, and hence this is called an inverting amplifier. Done. Now how about if you want the output to be of same sign, then what we call is a non-inverting amplifier. And because in the second stage of operational amplifier we have an unbalanced differential amplifier, that means one of the two transistor outputs will continue as an output. Therefore, it is not possible just to exchange these two terminals and then call the same circuit as non-inverting amplifier. No, that is not possible, because the second stage onwards, only the connection connected to this will always be negative, and connected to this will always be positive. We can't just interchange these two terminals, and we can't just use a similar type of circuit as we used here. So we can't do this, and even if you try to do this, what would happen is, because this is zero, this becomes zero, therefore there is a current here, this current will continue here, therefore, so you are going to get VO again negative. Therefore, this is not going to work. Then what should work is you somehow make sure that the current, current in this feedback resistance, which is R2, flows in this direction. If you make the current to flow in this direction, then this will be VO minus something, and if I can connect it to ground, yes, then this point voltage will become zero. So VO minus zero by R2, so now we get a positive current instead of negative current, because I want the current in this direction. In earlier case, the current was from input to output. Now if we get a current which can be from output to input side, then we can have VO minus 0 by R2 like thing, instead of 0 minus VO by R2, which is giving us negative sign. So we don't want this negative sign, then the current has to be in this direction. And to ensure that current flows in this direction, then we need another resistor. Then where is input? Yes, input should be here. Input should be connected here. Now what is happening is, because of this is connected to directly driving source VI, therefore this point voltage also will become VI, and if this is VI, then there will be some current I flowing, and that I will be VI minus 0 by R1, and the same current will flow V0 minus VI, this point voltage is not zero now, so V0 minus VI by R2. So when you say that the same current is flowing, because no current can enter into the operational amplifier, and because of the virtual short, this VI will be appearing here, and this VI will create this current, and this current has to make this current flow, because operational amplifier cannot allow current to flow in and out of its inputs. therefore it has to come from this, and that has to be driven from the output. So these two currents have to be equal, and if you equate them, then we get Vi by R1 will be equal to V0 minus Vi by R2, which is V0 by R2 minus Vi by R2. So this says that V0 by R2 will be equal to Vi by R1 plus Vi by R2. This comes other side. Then what is this? So if you take Vi common, then we have Vi 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, and that is equal to Vi R1 plus R2 by R1 times R2. And if you remember, the left hand side is having 1 R2, therefore that 1 R2 can cancel out with this R2. So finally we will have VO is equal to Vi times R1 plus R2 by R1, or in other terms we can say 1 plus R2 by R1 times Vi. Now what is it? All are positive terms, therefore VO is in phase with the Vi, so we get from this circuitry we get a non-inverting amplifier. With this circuitry we get an inverting amplifier, and with this circuit we get a non-inverting amplifier. So only thing is, you just decide what gain you want. So instead of using the same gain, use R2 by R1 ratio 1 less than that. So if you want a gain, voltage gain of say 20, if you want VO by VI is equal to 20, then you just decide R2 by R1 as 19. So R2 by R1 as 19 plus 1 will make 20. So that way VO will be 20 times VI. So just a simple adjustment will solve the problem. So same circuitry, little change is going to make an inverting amplifier into a non-inverting amplifier, and the whole computation and all depends only on the externally connected network, and hence it is very easy to design and use. So that's the advantage of working with operational amplifiers. Many more things to follow. So till then, take care, see you, bye.